Adding an animated character to your brand or social media posts has been a daunting experience. Until now. Starter mode in Adobe Character Animator is a free-to-use streamlined workflow enabling you to quickly create your own animations. Select a character from the home screen or import your own. You'll immediately see your character reacting to your face and voice in real time. You can start recording right away or import pre-recorded audio to perform against. Once you're ready, you can start recording your performance. When you're done, click the Finish Recording button. Now you can preview additional actions and emotions your character can have simply by hovering over them, giving a quick sense of your character's further animated possibilities. Simply drag any emotion trigger into your timeline to add it to your creation. When selected, the trigger can be expanded or trimmed, giving you full control over the final timing. You also have the ability to change the background image or adjust the formatting to better fit social media destinations. When you're happy with your animation, click the share icon and export out your final video. Or if you're a Creative Cloud subscriber, you can switch to Pro mode to continue creating with more advanced options. Within a matter of minutes, anyone can create a compelling, great-looking animation and have fun doing it. Hey everyone, this is Dave from the Adobe Character Animator team, and in this video, we're gonna do a walkthrough of Starter Mode. Starter Mode is a streamlined workflow in Character Animator that allows you to quickly select a character, record your face and voice performance, add some emotions and actions to your character, and export out a video in just a few minutes. So it's a really easy way to get into the world of character animation. And best of all, it's completely free. You do not need to be a paid Creative Cloud Adobe subscriber to have access to Adobe Character Animator Starter Mode. So if you don't have Creative Cloud, here's how to get started for free. Basically, go to creativecloud.adobe.com, and where it says here, download Creative Cloud, you're going to want to click on this button down here. That is going to download the installer, and then you can click that to install Creative Cloud on your Mac or PC. Eventually, it's going to ask you to either sign in or create an account. If you have an Adobe ID already, you can go ahead and add that in, or you can click on Create Account, and it's going to bring you to this page where you can fill in all your details and create your free Adobe ID account. So once you've installed everything and signed in and all of that, you're going to open up the Creative Cloud desktop app, and it's going to look something like this. Now, mine's a little different because I do have a paid account, and so I have all these different Adobe apps installed. But eventually, you should see somewhere on this main All Apps section of your Creative Cloud desktop app, you should see a bunch of different apps. And if you're a free user, a lot of these are going to say try or buy. You can do free trials or pay to be part of the Creative Cloud subscription plan. Or if you see Character Animator, which I already have, so it just says open, but you should see it down here and it should say just say install, and giving you the ability to just directly install it and be able to access it without needing to pay anything. You can find Character Animator both in the All Apps section or in the Video section, along with some of its siblings like Premiere Pro and After Effects. So after you're finished installing Character Animator, you should open it up and you'll see this, the Starter Mode home screen. Everyone is going to see this actually, whether they're a free or paid user. This is the new default that you are set into. And so I see that I've got a lot of different example puppets down here that I can use, different characters. If I'm a paid subscriber though, then I can go up here to Starter, where it says Starter has a little workspace icon, and I can click on this, and it gives me the option to move between the two modes. So while Starter is the best place to get started with quickly, if I want to go to Pro mode, I can go to Use Pro and switch back. And now I can tell I'm in Pro mode because it says Pro up here. Pro mode is basically what Character Animator has been for the past several years. All the usual bells and whistles that you're used to. But if you want the more streamlined version, or if you're a free user, you want to use Starter mode. Free users, if they go onto here, they're going to see something that allows them to do a free trial or buy Pro mode, be able to add to the Creative Cloud All Apps subscription, which Character Animator is a part of. All right, so now I've got all these different characters that I could choose from, and all of these are built into the app. So I've got a wide variety of characters and styles, or I can go over to Import Puppet. If someone, a friend or saying I bought on a website or something like that has a .puppet file, I can go ahead and import it directly here. Or if I want to find even more puppets, I can go to See More, this little button over here. And this has even more puppets for me to download, and we will be adding more puppets to this page in the future. So it's worth it to check back every once in a while. Okay, but for the sake of this video, let's just pick a character here. I like this one, Ava. This is a really cool looking kind of fantasy character. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on them. And now I should see myself in starter mode. You'll notice this is very different from the pro mode of Character Animator. There are not a lot of panels and icons and text all over the screen. This is a much more simplified and streamlined workflow for creating quick character-driven videos. Immediately, I should see as I move my head around, as I blink, as I raise my eyebrows, as I look around with my pupils, all that stuff, my character should be doing the same in the scene over here. If things aren't working, you should get a warning message telling you that a camera is busy or not available or something like that. You can also click into this little settings gear icon down here, and this will allow you to switch between different webcam inputs, visual inputs if you have them. It also allows you to go into your audio settings and change that. So if the lip sync isn't working as you would expect, you can select a different input here or try different things and see if that works better. For the lip sync to work properly, you want a nice, clean, loud signal coming in. So as I'm talking right now, my character's mouth is moving around pretty well, I'd say. And that's because if I look at this little green monitor over here on the side, it's looking pretty nice. It's getting pretty, that this bar over here is filling up pretty nicely. If I was too quiet like this, it wouldn't work very well. It wouldn't work well at all. And if I'm too loud, then it's not gonna be good either. So, you want to keep it at a nice range. The best place to change that is in your own OS microphone settings. So here I can see I'm using a MacBook Pro right now. I can see that this is pretty good. This is getting a nice loud signal. It's not clipping, it's not getting too loud, and it's also not getting too quiet. So let's go ahead and record something. I've got a few options here. You see these two buttons, record face and voice. So I could just press this. It's gonna do a little countdown and let me record a little performance where I'm moving my head and eyes and talking. Or let's say I have a friend who's a really talented voice actor, or someone else that I want to take their audio and use it to drive this character's voice. I can actually import an audio file and then do the face performance over top of that audio and then move on to the next step. For the sake of this video, we're just going to do record face and voice, but this process is very straightforward. I don't think you're going to have any problems if you try this method. All right, so I'm ready to go. I'm going to center myself, make sure I'm all nice and centered in the camera. Everything's looking good. I'm gonna go ahead and click record face and voice. It's gonna give me a little countdown down here, and I will now start talking. Hey everyone, welcome to Adobe Character Animator Starter Mode. It's pretty cool. So basically it's free. You don't need to know animation. You don't need to know anything about keyframes or complex limb IK rigging systems or anything like that. You just talk and move your head around and blink and all of that stuff, and you're going to get a cool little animated character performance. And if you like what you see, you can always do more in pro mode if you want to. All right, that's it for now. Bye. And when I'm done, I'm gonna go ahead and click this finish recording button. So now what's happened is my recording shows up down here as a track in this little timeline area. And if I didn't like it, if I thought I did a bad job, I could click the delete recording icon down here to start over to the recording step, or I can click undo, which is up here. Undo and redo make it very easy to kind of try different things. And if you don't like it, just undo it or redo it. So I can click and drag to kind of preview my recording and see how it looks. I can also press the play button here, or the spacebar will also automatically play. And I can just view it and make sure everything's looking as good as it possibly can be. So right away, I can tell that I don't need this whole section. I was talking a little bit at the beginning, so I'm just gonna click and drag this little trim handle to start here. And in the end, I said, I want to click the record button to stop. So I'm going to trim this out. And now I have a much nicer, more compact version of my recording. Now I have a few other options that I can do, and I can actually do this before the recording as well. But now that I've done my recording, I'm just going to play around with it a little bit. So first, if I click and drag over my character, I can reposition them wherever I want. So if I want this character more to the side, talking about something, a presentation, or up on this stump or anything like that, I have the ability to do that. If I drag them too far off the screen and now I can't find them or something like that, just double click anywhere on the screen and it's going to bring that character right back. I also have the option of changing the aspect ratio with this little icon down here. So if I wanted a portrait, for example, for maybe TikTok or Instagram, I could have it here. And again, I have the ability to move my character around wherever I want to fit within those parameters. And I can also click the background. If I click on this icon, we have a ton of built-in great backgrounds here made by some really talented artists that you can kind of play around with and see what looks best for what your character is trying to convey, what scene they're trying to do. I really like this one. This feels like a nice fantasy setting that this character would be in. And again, I can reposition them wherever I want, and that's looking pretty good. But my favorite part is this section over here, drag and drop triggers into the timeline. These are special emotions and actions that are unique to every character, and basically they just give them a little bit of extra emotion. So if I just played this back, I mean, this looks okay, but it's just kind of a talking head moving back and forth. If I want to, you know, wave or show some emotion, I can't really do that with just the webcam and my voice alone. But as I hover over these, I can see a preview of what's going to happen to my character. So here's a, you know, angry look, sad, shocked, point to the right, point to the left, a little wave there, great for the beginning and end of any of your sequences, question, a shrug, gesture to the right, left, both arms, arms out, kind of a little head scratch there, and then this nice little kick jump that I like as well. So I can really easily just preview any of these actions and say, you know, okay, at the beginning, yeah, I want this wave. So I'm going to go ahead and click and drag this down into the beginning of my timeline. And now this icon shows up to say where my wave is and where it begins and ends. And I can click and drag this to re-time, put in a different timing. I can click the edge, click and drag on the edge to make it longer or shorter if I want to. And if I click anywhere off of it, it's going to be deselected, but I'm still going to kind of see a little white overlay telling me where this wave begins and ends. So if I were to play this back now, I can see my performance that I recorded is still happening with the eyes and the head and all that, but this wave is now happening over top of it. So now is the fun part. I just kind of go through this and listen to what I was saying. And maybe this, I just need like a little neutral, you know, gesture to the side or something like that. And maybe I'll do another one like right here. But maybe at one point my character is kind of sad about something and I put it right there. And maybe I want to extend that a little bit more for this one sentence I'm saying. So I can keep playing around with these different emotions and just drag them in, change the timing and get it exactly like I want it. And just keep previewing. And if you don't like something, you can just select it and press the delete key, and that's going to get rid of it. You can, of course, undo or redo anything as well, and just see how the whole thing flows and get a nice little animation out of it. I love this system because at a glance, I can really quickly see, you know, the ups and downs of my performance, right? So I can tell I was a little bit, you know, surprised at this section or angry here or questioning here. It's kind of a nice overview of the recording that I did. So once I'm happy with all my emotions and how my character is looking and acting, I can go ahead up to the upper right corner. There's this little quick export share icon. Click on that, and it's going to bring up the ability to export out. So I can check where I want it to be saved and the file name, as well as different qualities. High quality is usually good for me, but if you were to want to, you know, text this to someone or something like that, you might want to go for medium or low quality. And then go ahead and click on export. And it's going to go ahead and export out the frames and create an MP4 file for you. And there we go. Now I can see my video file has exported out and it's looking great. And so now I could upload this to any, you know, social media destination, YouTube, wherever. So that's a basic walkthrough of starter mode. But here's a few tips and tricks for some other things that you can do kind of around the edges. So first, if I am a Creative Cloud subscriber, I can actually take my starter mode character and recording that I've made, go up here, say use pro, and now this character is going to show up in pro mode with all the usual bells and whistles. So I have full control over all the different behaviors over here, all the replays, all the triggers, all the different timeline tracks that I had. So if I want to really adjust the timing or blend things in and out, all the things that I can do that I've taught in all the other character animator tutorials, you can do that in pro mode. However, once you're in pro mode, you can't go back to starter mode because there's too many complexities and things that you can do in pro mode that we can't quite recreate in the limited interface of starter mode. So if now I was in a pro project and went to starter, it's just going to put me in the home screen and basically it's going to create a new blank project for me to get started on. So to go back to pro mode, I can just go back here, use pro, and make sure I'm in the correct project, which I know this one was called Ava Starter Project 3. And there you go. Now I'm back with my character. Now, if you wanted to use this character in other video programs, like let's say Premiere Pro, After Effects, or other video editing programs or compositing programs, and you're only a free user, you're not a paid user, there's a few ways around that. So for example, you could make the background green, something like this, and then use this as a green screen, and then bring this into other applications. And finally, for any pro users who want to rig your own starter mode ready puppets, the main thing you need to focus on, you rig them just like any other puppet, but the main thing you want to focus on is having one main triggers group swap set here, where you have a default setup and all sorts of different poses that the character can go between. And that is what you are setting in your controls panel over here. There's plenty of tutorials on the site that go into more detail about this, but at a base level, this is the main function for all those triggers in the starter mode. So what starter mode is looking for is this main controls panel, and it wants it to be a set of all these different posed replays that you're kind of switching between. So that is the easiest way to get a puppet that is very user friendly for the starter mode users. And then you can kind of show it like that. And it also is going to work in pro mode. It's not like it doesn't work in pro mode. It's just a little more constrained, and pro mode users may be wanting to be able to drag the arms around or do body tracking or some of the other features that you can do. So just a quick tip. So that's it. That's starter mode. And I could not be more excited, because one of the biggest goals of Character Animator has always been making animation as wide and accessible as possible. A lot of people are scared of the concept of animation. When you start talking about keyframes and limit case systems and stuff like that, it's really off-putting and scary to a wide portion of the audience. But something like this with starter mode, it's really easy to just jump in, move your head around, talk naturally, and add some emotions and create an animated video really quickly. So we're really excited. We can't wait to see what people create with it. Please, if you make anything, use hashtag character animator when sharing on social media so we can check out all the cool stuff that you've made. And if you're running into any problems, even though the interface is pretty simplified, if you're still not sure about what something does or wondering how to do things, the best place to get help is the official character animator forums. All right, that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching, and have fun.